most of the physical problems that we define in terms of line integrals are actually line integrals of a vector field, not of a scalar field. So in this video, I want to first define what does it mean to take the line integral of a vector field, and then I'll work some simple examples. So let's draw our curve. So that's our curve C. Now the curve is going to be directed, so it will have some direction. On this curve, we have a well-defined vector field. So let's say the vector field may be, say, pointing something like this on this curve. So this could be our vector field U. And at the same time, we have an element of the curve, say, pointing in along the direction of the curve always. And this element here, we're going to call dr. So the line integral of this vector field U along the curve, we're going to write as the integral along the curve of U dotted into dr. So it's basically saying that you have to take the component of U along the curve to do the line integral. But this is actually can be written in terms of a scalar, a line integral of a scalar field. If we say that dr, right, is equal to some tangent unit vector times ds, right? So we can define this vector dr of the small element as in the direction of the curve with the unit vector t hat, the tangent unit vector, times some length ds. Then this integral becomes the integral over the curve. Dr now is t hat ds, so it's u dot t hat times ds. And that's just the line integral of a scalar field. But here the scalar field is our vector field dotted into the tangent unit vector to the curve, okay? How do we compute such an integral? Usually we do it by parameterizing the curve. So we let r vector be a function of time. So then that dr becomes dr dt dt. And then this integral along the curve of u dot dr becomes the integral from the initial parameter t naught to the final parameter tf. So sometimes this is time, sometimes it's some other type of parameter, of u, now evaluated at r, which is evaluated at t, dotted into dr dt, and then integrated dt. That's how we would usually compute the line integral of a vector field. Okay, let me work then two examples. So I want to compute the line integral of the r vector field, so the position vector, which is xi plus yj, in the xy plane along two curves from the origin, 0, 0, to the point 1, 1. In the first curve, we're going to go first along the x-axis and then along the y-axis to get to 1, 1. So this is xy. In the second curve, we're going to go directly from the origin to the point 1, 1. Okay, so let's do the first one. We have two line integrals here, right? The first along the x direction, the second along the y direction. So in the first integral, we're going to have dr then is going to be equal to dx times the I unit vector. In the second integral along the y direction, we're going to have dr equal to dy times the j unit vector. So putting, then doing these line integrals, we have the line integral along this curve of r dot dr, then is going to be the integral along x. So x goes from 0 to 1. Since dr is along the I direction, it just picks out the xi vector from r. So this will be just x dx. Then the integral along the y direction will be dr is dyj. So r dot dr there will just pick out y. So that will be as y goes from 0 to 1, y dy. So this is 1 half x squared over 2 evaluated between 0 and 1. This one is also 1 half, and then the sum is 1. So this line integral is 1, both of them consisting of 1 half. Okay, what about the second curve? So curve number 2, what is r here? We can parameterize r as some t times I plus j, right? So it's going along this diagonal, so the x value is always equal to the y value, and then t goes from 0 to 1. So this point here is just the I unit vector plus the j unit vector. So that's the parameterization of the curve. So then dr is simply I plus j dt. Okay, then we have our integral then, our integral along the curve of r dot dr. So t goes from 0 to 1, so the integral from 0 to 1 of r dot dr. So we have I dot I is 1, j dot j is 1, the cross products are 0. So we end up with 2t dt, and that's t squared over 2. The 2's cancel from 0 to 1, and again we get just 1. Okay? So using these two curves, we get the same result. The line integral of the position vector from the origin to the point 1, 1 along the first curve, along the x-axis, then up the y-axis, is 1. And the same way if we just went from the origin to the point 1, 1 directly. Two different parameterizations of our curve. We did the integral and we got the same result. So let me summarize. To define a line integral of a vector field, we can define it in terms of a line integral of a scalar field, except that when we write it as the integral along the curve u dot dr, what we mean is the integral along the curve of u dotted into the unit tangent vector of the curve times ds, which is the line integral of a scalar field. Okay, to actually do this integral, we usually parameterize r, and then we write dr vector as dr dt vector times dt, and then do this dot product. Here I give you what are essentially two very simple examples. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.